If you want to see a beautiful world, you don't care about the gameplay, the grind, anything, just one of the most immaculate worlds ever, go play the game. Open world games get bigger and bigger every single year, and open sandbox is where it's at, to the point where some people, they want more linear games, which is crazy, but it's true. But today, we're going to go over my personal list. What is up, everybody? Chaos here. Welcome to Chaos Gaming, of the best open world games. These are those games that you can just immerse yourself and get completely lost in. In the comment section, you let me know, what do you think the number one game on my list today is? Drop a like. Remember, the PlayStation 4 giveaway is active. Somebody's gonna win it. All you have to do is drop that like. Make sure you have your post notifications on with subscribe. And in the comment section, tell me your favorite open world game of all time. Include your Twitter handle, and let's get into this. Saints Row 4. That's right, kicking off is a series that started off basically as just a troll. And then it grew into this wacky, weird giant as it went. The first Saints Row was a serious GTA clone. It was released in August of 2006, but Saints Row 4, well, it was an over-the-top superhero sandbox that was released in August of 2013. It boasted the best gameplay of the series. It had the sandbox. It had this crazy, crazy story too. Now, it's pretty funny to think about how the series started, and then it gradually progressed, but the end product, well, it was worth it. Saints Row 4 is some of the most fun you can have in a video game, just roaming around an open map, as there are tons of weapons, abilities, everything for you to mess around with the world, and react accordingly. It makes for endless entertainment as a gamer. Then, once you get bored of it, well, the story is actually really good, and you could just play through that. It's a good way to start today's video. At number 9, and some of you are going to be upset because this is lower down the list, but just hear me out and stick around. GTA 5. It's an obvious pick, okay? Grand Theft Auto 5 launched in 2013 for the PS3 and the Xbox 360 before being re-released on the 1 and the PS4 the following year, then the PC the year after that. Of course, the story had you following the three protagonists with varying motivations, and the sandbox was one of Rockstar's best of all the sandbox games set in modern day. GTA 5 is hands down the best. There is so much to do. It's so huge. Even to this day, there's a casino now. You can start your session in the city and then spend a bit of time driving and find yourself hiking through the mountains, and don't even get me started on all the potential with mods. If you've spent much time in Los Angeles, you probably know just how well Rockstar recreated this county and city for the game. It is an excellent game all the way around, one of the best of the decade, and if you're looking for an open world game to lose yourself in, well, GTA 5 has you covered. At number 8, depending on who you ask, Arkham Knight was either a disappointment or a proper send-off to the trilogy. Now, there was a ton of debate about this game when it came out, and fans are still talking about whether or not it lived up to the hype, but one thing that just about everybody can agree on is how great the open world was. Arkham Knight had by far the biggest sandbox in the series, and it was the first one to make use of the Batmobile, which you could summon at any time, although many people preferred the old-fashioned method of traversal, your grapple and glider, but Arkham Knight's world was also infested with tons of NPCs, side quests, random encounters, and Riddler challenges that would keep you occupied for hours upon end, days upon end, even without, I mean, that's not even the main content. Traversing around Gotham City was a ton of fun, and even if you were let down by Arkham Knight as a whole, this aspect was flawless. No other game will make you feel like Batman the way this one does. At number 7, once again, probably going to get some salty comments about how low this is, but hear me out. Red Dead Redemption 2, Rockstar's latest offering, was actually a prequel to the first Red Dead, and Rockstar really needs to get better at numbering their games. Now, the story was linear, and it was heavily structured, but the open world, oh my goodness, it was the exact opposite. It gave you free reign over a massive chunk of the Wild West. RDR2's map clocks in around 29 square miles, and you will definitely get lost while you're traversing it. And along the way, you are going to meet new characters, side quests, set up camp, get in a shootout or two, go hunt some legendary animals. I mean, some people prefer the open world of GTA 5 since it's more engaging and it's modern, but others prefer RDR2's open world thanks to the atmosphere and the heavier emphasis on survival. So I'm going to ask you, do you prefer roaming around GTA 5 or RDR2? And regardless of what you prefer, they're both excellent, deserving of places on today's list. At number 6, Breath of the Wild, another game that took the world by storm when it was released. Breath of the Wild was one of the launch titles for the Nintendo Switch, and it quickly became one of the main reasons to own the system, even though it was already released on the Wii U, but I mean, seriously, come on, nobody had a Wii U. Breath of the Wild was a total rework of the Zelda formula that still kept that core of venturing through dungeons and eventually doing battle with Ganon. But the way you did everything in between, it was completely redone and reworked. It was more of a survival game than before, but it was done in a way that was far less structured and there was very little direction given to the player, which allowed you to make your own decisions and figure it all out for yourself. And when you're making a game with such little structure, it can be hard to make it clear enough to the player where they're supposed to go or what they're supposed to do without forcing it in their face. But Nintendo found that perfect balance with Breath of the Wild. It is one of the best games of the decade and one of the most immersive open world games ever made. At number 5. Spider-Man 2. Now, you may have expected me to put the PS4 Spider-Man game on here, but instead, I'm going to go with a bit of a hot take, and I'm going to do Spider-Man 2 instead. Okay, this game launched back in 2004, alongside the movie with the same name, and it's widely considered to be one of the best movie tie-in games of all time, as well as one of the best comic book games, and it is not easy to have a good movie tie-in game, okay? It was developed by none other than Treyarch before Activision signed them on to Call of Duty. It had you playing this weird alternate version of the movie where you were still fighting Doc Ock and going over key plot points, but there was a ton of other villains and side plots at the same time. Now, the web swinging was designed to be as realistic as possible. In the open world, it was extremely detailed in order to complement this. The end result was a great game. It really was. Now, the combat may have not aged super well, but everything else about the game is excellent. I recommend you hit some old game shops or yard sales, see if you can snag a copy of this on the PS2 or the GameCube, and go give it a try. At number 4, you may not even remember this game. Prototype. Released back in 2009, this was one of the games that came during the trend of developers and publishers just wanting to see how far they could push the new console hardware, and despite Prototype kind of being forgotten, it's a great open world game. You played as a shapeshifter who's unleashed in the city of Manhattan, and you're trying to stop a mutant outbreak that ends up attracting both the US military and this mysterious task force called Blackwatch. So at this point, the game quickly becomes a frantic, over-the-top action sandbox where you can use superpowers to do pretty much anything you want. Which side do you want to fight on? Will you be a hero? Will you be a villain? Will you even pick a side? Are you just going to run around and destroy everybody in your path? The story was interesting, and I think it's one of the most underrated aspects of the entire game, but obviously, this is a video about the best open worlds. Your Prototype deserves that title. I would love to see this game get remastered on the next-gen consoles. Could you imagine this game with beefed-up graphics and a higher frame rate? At number 3, Skyrim. Launched on November 11th of 2011, 11-11-11, quickly exploded. Engaging character system, addicting world, open world, you played as the legendary Dragonborn as you set out to do various quests. You tried to beef yourself up in order to defeat the world-destroying dragon. However, a lot of people never even made it to the end of the main story because Bethesda had created such an immersive world with so many things to do that it was really easy to completely lose yourself in the side quest and the exploration. If you were bored, just load into your game, pick a direction, and start walking. And eventually you would find something new to do. And there has been a decent amount of debate over whether or not Skyrim was actually better than the previous game Oblivion, but given how insanely influential and impactful it was, it's not hard to put it on today's list, just specifically for the open world aspect. Raise your hand if you've watched The Witcher on Netflix. The Witcher 3 is another game that was super easy to lose yourself in. Rather than being a more custom character like in Skyrim, The Witcher 3 had you playing as Geralt of Rivia, a monster hunter setting out on this massive adventure to save his adopted daughter from the Wild Hunt, which is a mysterious army who are trying to steal her away and use her power for their own. Now, the open world in Witcher 3 is one of the biggest ever in gaming history. The whole thing is estimated at 136 square kilometers of land and sea for you to traverse. Now, the story, well, it'll take you all over the place. I mean, you got more missions, you can venture around, meet new NPCs, chart new areas, fighting various monsters. You can lose yourself in this world. And CD Projekt Red, they spent a ton of time crafting this thing. It has seen a huge resurgence thanks to the popularity of The Witcher on the Netflix. And if you haven't played it yet, I highly recommend it, especially in preparation for the studio's next game, Cyberpunk 2077. And at number 1, this is going to shock a lot of people, and I'm going to give you an honorable mention after number 1, the Just Cause series. Now, I know it's a hot take, but honestly, can you think of an open world game that gives you more control than this entire series? I didn't even want to pick a single favorite from the entry because they're all good. The first one was released in 2006. It got solid reception, but things really got crazy in 2010 with the release of Just Cause 2, which took the open world elements of the first game and cranked them up more than any other game at the time. You could do anything. Anything you wanted. Avalanche Studios, the developers, went to great lengths to make sure you were always engaged with the world, both in combat and when you were just traversing the map with your grappling hook and parachute. From that point on, the series continued to expand upon its philosophy of just making the world as fun as possible. And Just Cause 3 and 4, they were endlessly entertaining, even if they weren't quite as polished as the second one. Now, fans will debate endlessly which game was the best, but due to its consistency and how much fun every installment is, I just wanted to give the number one spot to the entire Just Cause franchise. And if we go off just beautiful open worlds, I have to give an honorable mention to Assassin's Creed Odyssey. If you want to see a beautiful world, you don't care about the gameplay, the grind, anything, just one of the most immaculate worlds ever, go play the game. And there you have it, my friends. Let me know one open world game that didn't make the list that was deserving. On the screen now are two videos, a red video and a blue video. Today, I'm going to ask you to click the blue video. I'll see you over there.